Previously on No Refunds.
Yes.
I apologize. What were you saying, Zil?
I don't know. There isn't really much. I mean, it could be a really short review.
Yeah, it would be. There isn't much to say about Vermintide. I don't hate it.
Well, want to put out a 2-second video that's just me saying Left 4 Dead with Swords.
Left 4 Dead with Swords is Vermintide. There you go.
just make that 2-second video. Just have you say Left 4 Dead with Swords. That's it.
That could be it. Maybe I will. Maybe like that'll be the opening, Left 4 Dead with Swords, and then I'll just let it be a black screen for like 10 seconds.
Like, you know, I'm serious. Put out a 2-second video. That's just you saying that. Well, I can't say words today. That's just you saying Left 4 Dead with Swords. That's it.
All right. All right. Fine. I will. I will make a video just like that, and then I'll do an extra one called the extended version. How about that? A compromise.
Yeah, that's perfect. Like, I put that video out 2 days later.
Yeah. I don't know what to say about Vermintide. Actually, here's something I can say that's good about it. The optimization seems pretty spot on.
Yeah.
The game looks great. The areas are beautiful. There aren't that many to go to. The character design is cool. I'd like to see more characters, personally. That's probably my only major gripe. But it's very repetitive. And honestly, it's got that Dynasty Warriors vibe to me, except with friends.
No, like I said, like Left 4 Dead, isn't it? Because it is essentially Left 4 Dead with swords. You got the hordes, you got like the specials.
Yeah, but you could like pick up better weapons in Left 4 Dead. More challenging too.
I mean, in this game you can too, but it's just at base, you know.
Yeah, but I want to be able to pick up something in game, you know.
Yeah,
like a special weapon you can't get in base to make it like some sort of little reward for keeping your nuts together.
I can combine that. I mean, the game does do some things differently, like you can pick up tomes or grimoires, which harden the level as you pick them up, and you have to find them through special jump puzzles, or they're very well hidden, you know. You gotta pull this lever, then walk all the way back and pull that lever, and then this door opens. You gotta scratch your balls, and then you find a grimoire. Mm-hmm. Or you pick up a grimoire, you lose like 50% of your health or some bullshit.
Yeah, but if you survive, that's when you get like the real payoff with loot boxes or chests.
Loot boxes.
The loot box system hasn't really impressed me. I don't find it too intrusive. It's not like I have to use money or anything, but it doesn't feel very rewarding. It's like, you got a chest, and you just hope to God it reaches like the highest level it can get to make it worth your goddamn while. It's a good time waster game, in my opinion. That's all it is. Like, if you got friends you could play with, it's perfect for wasting time. The only time it was actually interesting, or should I say punishing, is when we were playing with Twitch stream, and everyone called in the crazy hordes to finish us.
This boss is not happy. Get back.
I'm in flames.
He's still hurt.
Shit!
No, we'll never make that.
Fuck, please, we shouldn't have jumped down.
Oh no.
D-Girl, you're gonna have to vote for me.
I didn't think you'd vote a fucking other boss during a boss battle.
Anyone got any other bums?
No. All I have is my last thing of juice.
No, give me a potion! Wait,
Oops.
God damn it.
What did you need that potion for? I need it to run.
Ult is very strong. It's behind us. Oh, crap. Alright, we just gotta kill the main boss. Ignore the Balatro. Just kill the main boss.
I like the Balatro. No one else.
Fuck, I'm hurt.
I'm going to the Balatro.
Oh, you got the Balatro.
No one hit it until it was
a I think I missed.
Ah, shit.
God dang.
We gotta pick us up.
No shit, Sherlock. Oh, that was gay.
This is the end.
Wait, on my way.
Don't worry, Clanky's got it, man. I say pick up Zil.
I'll just swing.
Clanky, did you get Zil?
No, I got knocked back.
Oh shit. There's a health pack on the ground, ironically.
I dropped it.
Ah!
We're fucked. We can't win this.
Oh no.
Twitch champ got us.
God damn it.
The end was so close.
I was holding pair.
Thank you. Zell's really dead.
Dude, we can revive him in a sec.
What? Did there's another monster.
No, he'll be we have to rescue him. He's inside.
Ah, my ass! I was going to grab Zell.
I'm in the corner. I'm in the corner, Clanks, behind you.
No, let me revive Gundam. Jesus Christ.
There's still a chance. There's still a...
What's happening to me?
Fuck.
What the fuck?
It's the troll. It's the troll.
Yes.
Thank you for the follow. Fuck. Fucking Christ. I gotta run from this, dude. I'm hurt. There's shit everywhere.
They're gonna spawn in another one?
They're gonna spawn in an odd one, yeah.
Yep.
It's the Wraithy. Really?
Let's see how many we can get to summon.
Maybe all of them.
Ow, I can't even pick up Zill.
Oh, okay, well, I'm being eaten, so.
I just got. Oh, God. Oh, look what they're doing to his little.
I mean that is definitely a plus for the game. I don't think a lot of games. No, even some games do it. Just this whole interaction with Twitch. Yeah,
I hear that's going to be a thing.
I guess it doesn't apply to everyone who, you know, watches Zeru. They don't have, like, a Twitch channel or people to watch them, you know.
It would suck if it was, like, one person watching your Twitch that just didn't like you.
Quality crap on you.
But other than that, yeah. Nothing too amazing here. It's just a friend game, I'd say. I wouldn't rush to, like, if I didn't have anyone to play with, I wouldn't buy this. And it's not to say that you need friends to play with it. You can play with randos and quick play whenever you want.
So if you're a lonely fuck, like Gundam says, don't buy it.
Yeah, unless, like, you really are involved in this world somehow. Like, I saw there's a book to read about the lore, and
well,
I just...
the Warhammer.
Yeah, I couldn't be fucking bothered.
The Warhammer games are, like, 5 books and 3 screenplays and 2 movies. No, I'm just kidding. I mean, there isn't really much to say about. I mean, it's fun. There's a lot of variety. Variety.
Is that what you look for?
I was about to say Viagra for some reason.
Okay.
But I mean, each class has like 3 subclasses, and those classes all have different builds. So I guess that's. I mean, you know, there is more to your character than there was in Left 4 Dead.
Mm-hmm.
But we haven't played the first Vermin Tide, so we really wouldn't know how they compare up to those.
Yeah, I'm sure someone will get mad that we didn't buy the first Vermin Tide to know what the fuck was going on. I'm sorry. I regret to inform you all we're not rich.
But I don't think it's a bad game. I think it's a good time waster.
That's what it is to me.
With your friends.
If you got nothing else to do and your friend's like, what should we play? And you could probably pick up Vermin Tide, and that will kill some time. Before someone's just like, you know what, fuck this. I'm going to do something extreme. I'm going outside, Barry. And you're like, oh my God. The outside world.
I don't have enough money for outside. Nah, but I think it's a fun game. I don't know. I guess I don't like... Yeah, I guess the repetitiveness. It is really like Left 4 Dead. You know, you're doing the same shit over and over again. But I don't think the... Because Left 4 Dead had the director. And this one, you sort of have something equal to that. Like, mm-hmm. You know, an AI that sort of determines how your thing is going. I don't think Vermintide's director is as robust because each match does feel the same.
Oh, yeah.
Whereas definitely. Left 4 Dead, the director was very, very, very thorough, you know?
So the only option for variety and what the fuck happens is if you have a Twitch stream with people that actually watch you. Then, interesting shit can happen.
That is true. So if you don't have a Twitch following, don't bother.
Yeah. Like, if you want to actually experience madness, you need the Twitch people to just continuously send hordes after you. Like, that final match we played, dude, was actually interesting, and I wanted so badly to win. You know,
because there was no way of winning. They spawned in 3 rooms in the boss room when the boss was still alive. There was no way to win that.
I felt like there was, maybe it's just been me watch all this Dragon Ball Z Super. I was waiting for one of us to get Ultra Instinct. Go, Dushku, go.
I think I pissed my pants. I'll be right back.
I thought you were seriously going to piss your pants. Like, I got this text message about what I should have been doing with music, and it offset my brain power.
No, but I think it's a fun co-op game. If you're looking for... a game to play with your friends, definitely get it with your friends. It's not too expensive. It works technically. There's not a lot of bugs. There's not
exactly.
a lot of glitches.
That is like one thing you don't get much in the gaming world. Is a game that comes out. It's well optimized. You could play this at 4K with a 1080 Ti, which means like if you got a 1070 SLI, if you got a 980 Ti SLI, or even a 980 SLI, or any other derivative that's decent, you could probably enjoy this in 4K with the greatest of ease.
So I would say if you have friends to play with, yeah, sure, get it. It's a fun co-op game. If it's on sale, definitely get it. I think it's worth the money. You know, there's a lot of meat to this game, but you know, it's sort of like eating the same burger over and over and over again.
Yeah, you really gotta love McDonald's.
Like, yeah, it's a good burger, but I don't want to have to keep eating the same burger over and over again.
Agreed.
Because I think there is, well, there's three acts, four levels per act, as far as I know. Don't quote me on that, but, you know, there is some variety in levels, and I think the level design is pretty good, too. So, if you have friends, if you don't get it.
Yeah, when I first started playing it, I thought it was cool. I was like, oh, this is great. It's funny. Clanky's being eaten by this giant worm thingy. What a laugh riot. And then when it kept happening, my enthusiasm began to wane. Clanky's being eaten by the worm thing for the 1 trillionth time. What a riot.
Well, that's all I can say about the game. I really have nothing else to say about it.
I love that dog.
How are you going to put the dog down?
And when I get a gun, I'm going to give her a Viking's burial. Must be somebody downstairs.
I guess that's it.
Yeah, fuck it. Who cares? Fuck this.
Fuck this.
Ah!
Yeah!